वचन कसम पूरा गर्ने उहाँले वचन दिनुभएको थियो.
So he actually said, better I would die than to give up. Better I will die rather than break my promise.
बरु मेरो वचन जा वचन बचाउँछु तर बरु म मरोस् मर्नु राम्रो हुन्छ वचन भन्दा.
It's very common saying in Hindi language to understand the vow of truthfulness. Rahul Kali Rakchalai Pranjayaru Vachanajai. The better I will die rather than give up my promise. So Maharaj Dasara has to agree to allow Lord Rama to go, and Lord Rama goes along with Lakshman and they go with Vishwa.
र दशरथ महाराजले चाहिँ उहाँको आग्रहलाई स्वीकार गर्नुहुन्छ र रामचन्द्र चाहिँ विश्वामित्रसँग जानुहुन्छ.
And in this way, Lord Ramachandra was taught all the different mantras to kill the demons.
र यसरी नै रामचन्द्रलाई चाहिँ पूर्ण रूपमा चाहिँ यो राक्षसहरूसँग लड्नको लागि विद्याहरू विभिन्न किसिमको अस्त्र शस्त्रहरू दिन्छ उहाँ लड्नुहुन्छ.
It's the duty of the Kshatriyas to learn from the Brahmans.
र क्षेत्रीहरूको काम नै यो कि ब्राह्मणबाट यो सबै शिक्षा प्राप्त गर्नु.
So Vishwamitra was teaching.
र विश्वामित्र उहाँको गुरु
हुनुभयो. Lord Ramachandra is Maryada avatar. He is an incarnation of the Lord who shows the perfect etiquette.
र रामचन्द्र चाहिँ मर्यादा पुरुष हुनुहुन्छ र उहाँको जन्म नै यो मर्यादा देखाउनु.
He does everything, his behavior is very perfect. He would follow all of the principles, all the rules and regulations. So Lord Ramachandra went with Lakshman and they killed the demons. And then Vishwamitra brought Ram and Lakshman to the palace of Maharaj Janak. Because in the palace of Maharaj Janak there was the famous bowl of Lord Shiva.
भगवान् शिवको बाणहरू राखिएको
थियो. This bow was so heavy, it took 300 men to pick it up.
र यो धनुष यति गह्रौँ थियो कि त्यसमा 300 जना मान्छेहरू चाहिन्थ्यो त्यो बोक्नको लागि.
But Mother Sita, the daughter of Maharaj Janak, she could pick the bow up.
र जनक महाराजको छोरी सीताले चाहिँ सजिलै त्यो धनुष उठाएर सफा.
So Maharaj Janak wanted to get a husband who was suitable for his daughter. The man and the woman will make a good match when they are equal in qualities. If the man is a Brahmana and the woman is a Sudra, it's not a very good match. So Maharaj Janak had invited different kings to come, and the challenge was they have to pick up the bow of Lord Shiva and they have to string that bow.
त्यो राजाहरू रजोटाहरू सबै आउँथे र त्यो धनुष उठाएर त्यसमा तान दिनु पर्थ्यो, त्यसमा डोडी बाँध्नु पर्थ्यो.
So Vishwamitra brought Lord Ramachandra with Lakshman there.
र विश्वामित्रले चाहिँ रामचन्द्र र लक्ष्मणलाई लिएर जनक महाराज कहाँ आउनुभयो.
And they showed him the bow of Lord Shiva.
र त्यसपछि ऊ शिवको धनुष त्यही हो भनेर देखाउनुभयो.
And Lord Rama, of course, he offered his respects to the bow, then he picked up the bow and he strung it, and just as he was going to fire an arrow, he broke it, the bow snapped.
Ramachandra aunu bhayo, dhanush uthaunu bhayo, tesma dori bannu bhayo, ra baan hanera tankaunchu bhanera tankaunchu bhanera tukra parinu bhayo.
So anyway, it was agreed that Sita was now going to be the wife of Lord Ramachandra. Actually, Mother Sita was born from the earth. She was not a normal
birth.
But she was found by Maharaj Janaka. When Maharaj Janak was plowing the field one day, performing sacrifice, at that time, Mother Sita appeared from the air. So Mother Sita is the eternal consort of Lord Ramachandra. Just like Lakshmi is the consort of Lord Narayan. So Sita is the consort of Lord
Ramachandra.
So it was arranged that they would have a big wedding, and it was arranged also they would bring a wife for Lakshman also. And the two other brothers, Bharat and Shatrughna, marriage was also arranged for them. So in this way, the four brothers were all married. Kshatriyas, they will all be married people usually. Because Kshatriyas, they want to have descendants. To continue their line. Some Kshatriyas, they didn't marry. Like grandfather Bhishma. Didn't marry. But that was special. Okay, so they all came back to Ayodhya. So it happened, Maharaj Dasarath was getting old and he wanted to give up the throne. So he thought that Lord Rama is the oldest son, he should become the king. Everyone loves him, everyone likes him, I think he will make a nice king. So Maharaj Dasarath announced that we will have the coronation of Lord Ramachandra, my son, will take place tomorrow. But at this time, Bharat and Shatrughna were far away at some relative's house. So when the news was announced, then this one hunchback servant of Kaikeyi, what was the name? Mantara. She was an evil-minded woman, and she came to Kaikeyi and she polluted her mind. And she told her, if this if Rama becomes a king, then his mother will be more important and you will not have any position. And your son also, Bharat, will have no position, he won't be anybody important. Rama will take everything and Rama's mother will have all the position and all the glory. So Mantara told Kaikeyi that you have to get your husband to agree to send Ram to the forest. How many years? 14 years, is it? And Mantara told Kaikeyi that your husband has promised you two boons. Previously you had helped him when he was injured in the battle. And at that time he was so grateful to you, he promised you that you could have boons, whatever you wanted. But you have never taken anything. But now you have to tell him what you want. And you should tell him, I want Ram should go to the forest for 14 years and my son Bharat should be the king. So Mantara told Kaikeyi, you go to the morning room. Because they're living in a palace, there's many rooms there. So one of the rooms were for people who were not feeling good, who were not
happy.
So Kaikeyi went there and she put on her old dress and she lay on the floor and waited for her husband to come. So Dasarath came and he's thinking, where is my wife? Where is my nice young wife? And he was surprised to hear, she is in the morning room. She is mourning. She's not happy about something. So immediately he went there to see what was wrong. And he sees Kaikeyi laying on the floor there and dressed in old garments and looking very miserable. So Maharaj Dasarath comes and says, oh, my dear wife, what is wrong? Why are you in this condition? What can I do to make you happy? And Maharaj Dasarath offers so many things. Do you want jewelry? Do you want wealth? Do you want, what do you need to make you happy? So then she looked him in the face and she told him, do you remember you promised me two boons?
उहाँले अनुहार दशरथ अनुहारेर भन्नुहुन्छ तिमीलाई याद छ तिमीले मलाई दुईटा आशीर्वाद दिन्छु भनेको थियो.
सो दशरथ सेड यस बट व्हाट डू यू वांट.
र मलाई याद छ तिमी भन न के छ.
सो देन शी सेड First of all, send Ram to the forest for 14 years.
र पहिलो आशीर्वाद मलाई यो दियो कि रामचन्द्रलाई 14 वर्ष वनवास पठाइदियो.
And let Bharat become crown king.
र दोस्रो भरतलाई राजा बनाइदियो.
So when Maharaj Dasharatha heard this, he fainted. He could not believe.
जब महाराज दशरथले यो सुन्नुभयो, हैन उहाँलाई विश्वासै लागेन, उहाँ मूर्छा भयो.
He thought, please, let it not be true. Let it just be my imagination. Please don't let this be
happened.
But Kaitiya was very insistent. Yes, this is what I want, and if you don't give it to me, then you're not king anymore, you're not truthful. So he tells Kaikeyi, if I give you this, then you're not my wife anymore. My son Ram is more dear to me than anything. I cannot live without him.
र मेरो छोरा राम मलाई एकदम मन पर्छ र म ऊ बिना बाँच्न सक्दिन.
But Kaikeya is insistent. You promised me two boons. Now you should keep your word.
र Kaikeya चाहिँ लगातार यही दुईटा आशीर्वादको कुरा गर्दैछ र तिम्रो वचन पूर्ण गर्नुपर्छ, वचन पूर्ण गर्नुपर्छ भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ.
So Lord Maharaj Dasarath was in this very difficult position. He did not want to even look at Kaikeyi anymore. But he had to keep his promise. So he said, call for Lord Ram. Tell Ram to come here. So he came, and then Kaikeyi told him that your father wants you to go to the forest for 14 years.
र रामलाई त्यहाँ बोलाइयो र त्यसपछि राजा दशरथ कैकेयीले भन्नुभयो कि तिम्रो पिताजीले भनेको तिमी 14 वर्ष वनवास जानुपर्छ अरे.
And Lord Rama said, yes, if my father wants, then I'm ready to go. I will go tomorrow.
र रामचन्द्रले भन्नुहुन्छ, ओहो, मेरो पिताजी यो चाहनुहुन्छ भने म त तुरुन्तै तयार छु 14 वर्षलाई, भोलि नै जान्छु.
Why tomorrow? I will go today.
किन भोलि जाने? आजै जान्छु.
If my father wants, I will do whatever he wants.
र यदि मेरो पिताजी यही चाहनुहुन्छ भने पिताजी जे चाहनुहुन्छ म त्यही गर्छु.
So this is the mood of Lord Ramachandra.
र यो रामचन्द्रको
One moment the king is telling him to become Maharaj Dasarath is telling Lord Rama, I want you to become the king.
र एउटा समयमा दशरथ महाराज भन्नुहुन्छ कि तिमी राजा बन.
Next minute, he's telling him, I want you to go to the forest for 14
years.
Lord Rama is ready to do whatever is the order of his father. So the duty of the son is to carry out the order of the father.
र छोराको कर्तव्य यही हो कि बुवाले जे भन्नुहुन्छ त्यही चिज गर्ने.
The son is called Putra. Putra means the one who saves the father from going to hell.
र छोरालाई पुत्र भनिन्छ. पुत्र भनेको त्यो व्यक्ति हो जसले आफ्नो पिताजीलाई नरक जानबाट रोक्छ.
So Maharaj Dasarath is broken hearted. He does not want Lord Rama to go.
र दशरथ महाराजको हृदय छिया छिया पर्छ र
Lord Ramachandra is ready to go alone. But then it happened that Lakshman said that I will go with you. Then why you should go alone? Lord Rama likes to deal always with his devotees. Actually, the four brothers, Ramachandra, Lakshman, Bharat, and Shatrughna, they are all Vishnu Tattva. They are all like God. But Lord Ram is a senior and the others are his servants. So Lakshman said, I will go with you. And then Sita said, I also want to come. Lord Ram said, oh no, 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 we cannot take a woman there.
And Ramchandra went, no, 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 something would then
very dangerous to go in the forest. Many rakshasas. And there is no comfort, no luxury for you. To go to the forest means to take the dress made of bark of trees. And the hair should be matted. And no jewelry. So Sita had been living in a palace all of her life, but now she wants to go to the forest. So Lord Ramachandra tried to persuade her not to come. But he could not convince her. She was insisting that, no, I want to be with my husband. It's the duty of the wife to be with the husband. When the husband goes to the forest, the wife also will go with
it.
So Sita, Rama and Lakshman, they all went to the forest. And they dressed in the bark of trees. Sita did not even know how to wear, how to put on the dress. She had to be shown how to wear this dress. And the people of Ayodhya, they loved Lord Rama so much that they said, we will follow, we will come with you. But Lord Ramachandra said, if you all come with me, then the city will become the forest, and the forest will become the city. So you all have to stay here. Siti means
Ayodhya.
So the birthplace of Lord Ramachandra is there in Ayodhya. In the course of time, somehow a Muslim temple was built on the birthplace. But somehow over the years, they managed to remove the Islam temple. And now they have built a temple to Lord Ramachandra. The birthplace is very important. So in the past, India has been ruled by Islamic rulers, people like Aurangzeb.
भारत में सही मुस्लिम अली कब्जा करे कुछ नहीं जस्ते औरंगजेब जस्ता राजा रहेगा थी
and this Aurangzeb was very powerful he went everywhere breaking temples smashing deities
Aurangzeb धेरै शक्तिशाली थिए र वहाँ चाहिँ विभिन्न ठाउँमा गएर मन्दिरहरू भत्काउने मूर्तिहरू उडाल्ने जस्ता कामहरू गरे
he wanted to also he also built the mosque at the birthplace of Lord Rama
र उसले नै रामचन्द्रको जन्म स्थानमा मन्दिर भत्काएर मस्जिद बनाए
Even at the birthplace of Lord Krishna, there's a mosque.
Ra even Mathura ma pani Krishna ko janma bhumi ma masjid banayeko
cha. There's also today there's also a big temple.
Ra aaja ko din ma tyo thau ma pani mandir banisakeko cha.
So Lord Ramachandra went to the forest and he lived in the forest for 14 years.
त्यसरी रामचन्द्र जङ्गल गएर चौध वर्ष वनवास बस्नु भयो
Of course, Lord Ramachandra has a mission when he comes into this world.
रामचन्द्र यो संसारमा आउनु हुँदाखेरि केही लक्ष्य लिएर आउनु भएको थियो
परित्रनाय सदनम विनस छाय चतुष्कुलो When the Lord comes in this world, his purpose is to kill the demons.
र जब जब भगवान् यो संसारमा हुनुहुन्छ उहाँको एउटा लक्ष्य के हो राक्षसहरूलाई नष्ट गर्ने
Lord Ramachandra went to the forest. He took with him his bow and arrows, and in the course of his 14 years in the forest, he killed many rakshasas.
र उहाँले आफ्नो धनुष बाण पनि साथ लिएर जानुभएको थियो र जङ्गलमा कैयौँ राक्षसहरूलाई उहाँले बध गर्नु भयो
Of course, he also They also he had Mother Sita kidnapped by Ravana. But then with the help of Hanuman and the other monkeys, he recovered Mother Sita. They found out that Ravana had taken Sita the island of Lanka.
पछि थाहा भयो कि रावणले सीतालाई चाहिँ लङ्काको काबुमा लिएर गएको थियो
So Lord Ramachandra was so angry, he was going to burn the ocean.
र रामचन्द्र यति रिसाउनु भएको थियो कि त्यो पुरै टापुले समुद्र नै जलाइदिन्छु भनेर रिसाउनु भएको थियो
But the deity of the ocean came before him and begged Lord Ramachandra to build a bridge across the ocean.
तर रामचन्द्रलाई चाहिँ समुद्र देवले आएर आग्रह गर्नुहुन्छ कि बरु पुल बनाउनुहोस् सेतु बनाउनुहोस् नजलाइदिनुहोस् भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ
In this way, Lord Ramachandra, with his army, bears and monkeys, he crossed over to Lanka.
र त्यसरी त्यहाँ सेतु बनाउँछ अनि पुल बनाएर त्यसमाथिबाट बानर र भालुहरूको जुन सङ्ख्या छ उहाँहरूलाई लिएर गएर लङ्कामा आक्रमण
गर्छ And Lord Ramachandra killed Ravana and his brother Kumbhakarna. And he brought back Mother Sita. And then the 14 years was finished and Lord Rama went back to
Ayodhya.
Now during the 14 years at that his father had already left the world.
जब 14 वर्ष भित्रमा के भयो त भन्दाखेरि आफ्नो पिताले यो संसार छोडेर जानु भइसकेको थियो.
The father, Dasara, one day he was hunting.
एक दिन दशरथ चाहिँ शिकारमा जानु
भयो. And he had some voice, he heard the sound, he thought it was a deer. But when he fired the arrow, he heard a human voice. Then he went there and he found out that he had killed a human person. He thought he was killing a deer. So the person who he killed with his arrow, in his dying words, He told Maharaj Dasaratha, he said, please go and tell my mother and father how you have shot your arrow into me and I won't be able to come home and take care of them. The man was living like a brahmachari. He was taking care of his mother and father, and he'd just gone to get some water from the river. But Maharaj Dasara thought it was a deer. And he fired the arrow, killed the man. So then Maharaj Dasara went to find the mother and father. And he told them what happened. So the couple, they were both elderly and invalid. They were not able to take care of themselves. They were depending on their son to take care of
them.
But now their son had been killed. So the couple decided, there's no point in us living any longer. We will also give up our life. So they built a fire, and both the man and woman entered into the fire, giving up. But before they entered into the fire, they told Maharaj
Dasaratha.
They said, because of you, we have to die without our son present. So, the same will happen to you. You will also die without your son being present. And it happened. Lord Ramachandra had gone and Maharaj Dasara was at home and he
died.
So this is basically what happens in Ramayana. It's a lot of tragedy. But there's a lot of ecstasy also. It's the pastime of the Supreme Lord. Any question?
So the man who gave prasnata?
So Lord Ramachandra has his own abode in the spiritual world, that is Ayodhya. All the devotees, when Lord Ramachandra finished ruling the world, he ruled the world for thousands of years, and then he left the world, and he entered into the Sarai, into the Sarayu River, and he went back to Godhead. And all of his devotees, the people of Ayodhya, they followed him. They also entered into the Sarayu and went to the spiritual world. But Hanuman, he stayed. Lord Ramachandra told Hanuman, you don't need to come back to Godhead. You stay here and preach.
Okay. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Krishna.
Shri Prabhupada ki
jai.
Shri Ramachandra Bhagavan ki
jai.
Hare Hare.